Welcome back to the channel site FYI. I am so glad that all of you came back to us for more information about natural preventions against COVID-19. This episode, myself, Vedangi, and my colleagues,
Vedika,
Kalyani,
Purva,
Aditi,
talking to you about some of antiviral Indian medicinal plants and their metabolites proposed for COVID-19.
The COVID-19 pandemic is now in a manageable state. Vaccines are under circulation in markets. People are getting more vigilant and the global governments are easing into managing the population. But the identification of a mutated coronavirus strain calls for immediate precautionary measures.
Unlock phase calls for reopening of the economy. But are we really ready? How much do we have at risk if we step out of our homes?
How can we divert from getting infected? How can we keep ourselves healthy and protected at home itself?
Here we bring to you an episode focusing on some naturally occurring Indian medicinal plants having antiviral properties and their metabolites which are proposed for the COVID-19 treatment.
Metabolism is the sum of all the chemical reactions that take place within each cell of a living organism and provide energy and also help in synthesizing new organic material.
Metabolites are organic compounds that are starting materials or intermediates in metabolism pathways. They are small, simple structures absorbed in a diet. They include vitamins and essential amino acids. They can be used to construct more complex molecules or they can be broken down into simpler ones.
There are two types of metabolites, primary and secondary. A primary metabolite is a type of metabolite that is directly involved in the normal growth, development, and reproduction. Secondary metabolites are derived by pathways in which primary metabolites involve. Thus, a metabolite is an intermediate or end product of metabolism. The term metabolite is usually used for small molecules.
Phytometabolites are plant metabolites. They have properties which help us get relief from ailments. They can be volatile or in aqueous, and they may be readily potent or may accumulate slowly.
Let's have a look at some of the antiviral Indian medicinal plants and their metabolites proposed for COVID-19.
Tinospora cordifolia. It is also known as guduchi or guival. It balances three dosha in our body. It is highly rich in antioxidant. It also has antipyretic, antiviral, and wound healing properties. Tinospora cordifolia extract is a plant-derived immunostimulant and immunomodulator, stimulating T and B lymphocytes. This herb also acts as an antispasmodic agent which suppresses muscle spasm during the time of infection. Tinospora cordifolia extracts has been shown to demonstrate a decrease in recurrent resistance of HIV and thus improving therapeutic outcome.
Withania somnifera or ashwagandha. It is suggested that ashwagandha would be an effective agent in the management of COVID-19 through modulation of host Th1 or Th2 immunity. It may be beneficial in inducing antiviral immunity and optimum anti-inflammatory activities, which are the key targets relevant to COVID-19. Withanolites from Withania somnifera have been identified to regulate P53 signaling by regulating caspase and CHK1, which could contribute to maintaining the cell apoptosis during viral infection and removing dead cell, thus minimizing inflammation in human cells.
Glyceria glabra gestamol. Ancient manuscripts from China, India, and Greece mention its use for symptoms of viral respiratory tract infections and hepatitis. It has been known to target the viral replication of SARS-CoV, arising as promising candidates against SARS-CoV-2. Glycyrrhiza glabra derived compound glycyrrhizin and its derivatives reduced hepatocellular damage in chronic hepatitis B and C. In hepatitis C virus-induced cirrhosis, the risk of hepatocellular carcinoma was reduced. Animal studies demonstrated a reduction of mortality and viral activity in herpes simplex virus encephalitis and influenza A virus pneumonia. In vitro studies revealed antiviral activity against HIV-1, SARS-related coronavirus, respiratory syncytial virus, arboviruses, vaccinia virus, and vascular stomatitis virus. Mechanisms for antiviral activity of Glycyrrhiza species include reduced transport to the membrane and CLylation of hepatitis B virus surface antigen, reduction of membrane fluidity leading to inhibition of fusion of the viral membrane with the cell, induction of interferon gamma in T cells, inhibition of phosphorylating enzymes in vesicular stomatitis virus infection, and reduction of virus latency.
Syllabum marianum, milk thistle. The major component of S. marianum fruit extract, silymarin, is a flavonoid lignin called silibin that has been used in Indian medicines for liver and gallbladder problems. Major studies have also reported that silymarin is an effective antiviral for hepatitis C virus, HCV. Silymarin is a complex mixture of polyphenolic molecules including 7 closely related flavonolignans, silibin A, silibin B, isosilibin A, isosilibin B, silicristin, isosilicristin, silidianin, and one flavonoid, taxifolin, and has a long tradition of being used as a herbal remedy. The major bioactive component, silibinin, exerts antiviral effect against HCV by blocking calathrin-mediated endocytosis.
Trichocynthus kirillovi or jungli padwal. It is a useful source of trichobetasin, a ribosome inactivating protein which can be extracted from its root. It has been proved to exhibit anti-HIV activity as evident from the reduction in expression of the P24 HIV-1 antigen.
Adhatoda vesica, that is ADUSA, is a mucolytic expectorant and bronchodilator in action. So, it is greatly used in respiratory troubles. It relieves cough, fights off respiratory infections, and helps in the management of asthma. It is an effective yet gentle antitussive. A study conducted on mice showed that this herb not only reduced the amount of effort to cough but also relaxed intercostal muscles. Adhatoda vesica has been a potent herb against bronchitis in Ayurveda due to its affinity for the lungs as well as its cooling and lubricating actions.
A study has shown anti-mouse coronaviral activity, a surrogate SARS-CoV, using some of this plant. Vitex trifolia and Spheranthus indicus, also known as Nirgundi and Gorakhmundi in local languages. They have been found to reduce inflammatory cytokines using NFK-beta pathway. This is a pathway that has been implicated in respiratory distress by SARS-CoV. Clytoria ternata, also known as Shankhapushpa. It has been identified as a metalloproteinase inhibitor. ADAM17 is a metalloproteinase that is involved in ACE shredding. ACE shedding has been associated with increase in formation of SARS-CoV virus. So, it can be targeted using this plant.
Cleodendron inerm girte, wild jasmine or vanazai has been found to have the potential to inactivate the viral ribosome. This can be further investigated for its utility as a drug targeting SARS-CoV-2 protein translation. Strobilanthus cusea, curvy, block the viral RNA genome synthesis and induce papain-like protease activity targeting the HCoV.
Andrographis paniculata or Kalmeg. It is present in South Asia and has a strong treating capacity of viral respiratory infections in Ayurveda and other medicinal systems. It was noted that Andrographis paniculata suppressed increased nod-like receptor protein 3, caspase 1 and interleukin 1 beta molecules, which are extensively involved in the pathogenesis of SARS-CoV and likely SARS-CoV-2 as well.
Now, the take-home message is, the plants like gurvel, ashwagandha, jeshthamath, milk thistle, jangli padwar, adusa, nirgundi, gorakhmundi, shankhapushpa, vanazai, karvi and kalmeet have diverse metabolites with numerous medicinal benefits that can be effective against viral infections. Exercise and proper balanced diet lead to a happy and healthy life.
Thank you everyone for watching the video. If you want to read more, links are in the description box.
If you found our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe to our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon.
Thank you. Take care and stay safe.